Thank you for coming to my grandpa's life celebration today. I am Ayana, his oldest granddaughter. My father is Jonathan. I am going to share a letter I wrote at school for my grandpa. I wrote this letter in Spanish, but there is a translation in the bulletin. Mi abuelo Adam era una persona muy feliz y cariñosa. Mi papá y toda la familia lo amaba y él amaba a todos también. Toda la familia está triste, pero sabemos que ahora estás en un lugar donde ya no estás sufriendo. Está en el cielo con Jesús. Jesús lo va a ayudar y cuidar mucho. Más que nada, te amo mucho, abuelo Adam. Siempre estarás en mi corazón y en todos los corazones de la familia. Voy a tratar de ser una buena prima a Kayla y Kelsey. Les voy a contar historias sobre ti y ella, que ellas sepan de ti. Voy a apoyar a mi tía Alison para que sepa que somos familia y la amamos. Te amo. Besitos.
I just want to thank you all, everyone, for coming. My name is Andrew Sanchez, and I am Adam's youngest son. For the past 4 years, I've been studying music at SFA, Stephen F. Austin. And if you know anything about Nacogdoches, Texas, you know it's a bit of a drive. So, understandably, my family hasn't been able to come to a lot of concerts, but anytime I let my dad know about a live stream, watching, even if it was in a hotel room on a trip for work. And I was blessed to have him at my senior recital back in April. During the 5-hour drive down here on Tuesday, I had a lot of time to think, and the text of this hymn that I'm about to sing was one of the things on my heart. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to thy light. Take my hand. Precious Lord, lead me home. When my way grows drear, precious Lord, linger near, and my life is almost gone. Hear my cry, hear my call. Precious Lord, lest I fall, take my hand. Precious Lord, lead me home. When the darkness appears, precious Lord, draw me near, and the day is past and gone. Stand, guide my feet, hold my hand, take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home.
to say ever since I found out, and I didn't know how to put it together. I just wanted to say thank you to him because it must have been really hard for him raising someone that's old enough to be his youngest or his granddaughter. I always mess around with Matthew or Jonathan saying, you know, you're old enough to be my dad. And
right.
And then I say, Dad really knew how to plan out when he has kids. But I really just wanted to thank him because he was an amazing dad, even though it may not be easy to understand a 13-year-old girl when you're 54. He really knew how to put up with everything that went I could tell him almost anything, and he understood, and he knew exactly what to say. And I'm really gonna miss him, but I know that so are a lot of people, and I know to stay strong, because I will see him again when I'm up in heaven with him. I just wanted to thank everyone that's here, and thank you for supporting my family through this really hard time.
I'd like to thank everybody for coming and showing their love and care for my dad. And it's amazing to see how many people that he's touched throughout the years, through HEB, through Kielbasa, and just day to day. And I'd like to read something. Although you are no longer here with me, I want you to know how much I loved you when I was lucky enough to have you in my life. I want you to know that even though you are no longer with me, I still think about you and miss you so very much. Love you, Dad.
Jonathan Sanchez. I'm Adam's second oldest son. Before I begin, I'd like to say something that's been really weighing on my heart. And it's if you're going through difficult times or struggling in any type of way, I ask that you please reach out and seek help. I think men, especially Hispanic men, are conditioned to be hard and told that expressing your feelings or struggling with something is a sign of weakness. And that's false. I think we should all aspire to have confidence with vulnerability, especially men.
Good. Good.
All right, so as you can imagine, it's been emotional roller coaster the last few days. On one hand, the support we've received from friends and family has been overwhelming. While taking care of my dad's affairs, my family and I have even been able to share a few laughs. On the other hand, I lost my dad. I've been thinking a lot about what I should share with you today and decided to talk about some lessons learned. Most of these lessons were not necessarily taught directly. You knew my dad, he wasn't much for dialogue, but if you paid attention to the way he lived his life, he had clear principles and convictions that I think were instilled in me. He taught me that forgiveness is really for the one doing the forgiving, not for the one needing forgiveness. So forgive early and forgive often. He taught me about hard work. I mean, there's been a lot of testimony about his work ethic. I tell a lot of people stories about when me and my older brother were little, that we used to have to, they ran a paper route, and we used to have to hide under covers in the car because the guy they were running paper routes for didn't want them to bring their kids. And this is like at 3 or 4 in the morning before they went to their, 8 to 5 jobs. I have memories. My summers and weekends are filled with memories of getting up early, grabbing some barbacoa, eating at my grandparents' house, and then getting work done. Taught me how to tie a tie, handy today. He taught me to have respect for my elders, to respect tradition. We have a lot of traditions in our family, and although our family has evolved over the years, we've stuck to a lot of those traditions. He taught me how to respect the church. If you're acting up in Sunday school or Royal Rangers, and suddenly you felt a rough hand come underneath your arm for a pinch, you knew that the commander or the Sunday school teacher got in front of Dad and he was motivating you to do better. He taught me just because you discipline your kids doesn't mean you're mad or you hate them. Because you want what's best for them. And you're trying to point them in the right direction. He taught me that truth is truth, even if you don't like the person it's coming from. He taught me to love your family. While I was taking care of my dad's affairs, I wanted to see him, so I decided to look at his Facebook. I noticed two things. One, the man had more friends than I did. He was definitely dedicated with his, you know, signature selfies. And two, most of his pictures were of his kids or his grandkids. He really loved his family. Taught me to be there for friends. Whatever my dad could give, he would, whether time, money, vehicles, friends, he wouldn't hesitate. He taught me that it speaks volumes what people say about you when you're not around. I met quite a few old friends, managers, colleagues, employees that knew my dad, and they always speak highly of him, always with the highest admiration. He taught me to sing in the car. My dad loved 80s rock, and he would do a lot of air drums and air guitar. I take my daughter to school every day, and that's something we practice often. It's not going to be easy, but life moves on. On the day my father passed away, I believe we had at least two friends in our circle have children, and then there was one engagement. That's the deal. You got to take the good with the bad. There's no perfect life. Few perfect days, but there are a lot of perfect moments. I definitely shared some perfect moments with my dad, and those are the ones I'm going to choose to remember. In closing, I'd like to say, Dad, in a lot of ways, I'm just like you. I'm going to think about you often. Every Cowboys game, every time I see a bag of candy mints, every time I see a sweater vest or someone wearing their glasses on their forehead. Every time I see a softball field, while I'm washing my car, mowing my lawn, when I hear Christmas music or 80s rock, when I see my sisters, Addison and Jennifer, when I see my brothers, Andrew and Matthew. I love you, and I hope you felt honored these last 2 days. Rest in peace, and I'll see you again.
This room, and I see love. I see people who love us. I see people who love my dad. And I'm just honored to stand here before you to honor my father. I'm really, you know, Jonathan came up with this long piece of paper, and I feel inadequate with what I wrote. But I didn't really want to take up too much time. I just wanted to say thank you to each and every one of you. What I've seen the past few days has been amazing. I have people that are coming to me, telling me stories about my dad, and people who are just